Weekly update with the head coach of Jackrabbit Wrestling, Damion Hahn. Always good to catch up, my friend. And we chatted a week ago that finals were just about to begin and how important academics are. Now we're coming down the home stretch. They're virtually in the rearview mirror. How did you think finals week went for the squad?
It was good. They finish up tomorrow. We had a good week, last week of training, and, you know, with finals kind of coming to a close, we'll get these last couple days in of training, getting ready for this weekend. I'm hoping that everything's looking good up to this point as far as academically. There could always be a last minute kind of interruption, I guess, but for the most part, I think our guys are right on top of where they need to be, academically.
This probably most challenging for your first year student athletes, your incoming freshmen, because you talk about it, but until they go through it once, they don't really know what this process is all about.
For sure. I think as a program, and every program handles their academics a little bit different. Study halls or mentoring them on the process and, setting up good work habits and study skills. I think our program in particular does a really good job with just educating our kids in time management and literally teaching them the skills that they need because, hey, these kids come from all walks of life, right? They come from all parts of the country and some of them are, I don't want to say more intelligent than others, but they come in with a good foundation and they kind of just hit the ground running where other kids, this is completely new and different. They're away from home. They don't have mom and dad, saying, hey, did you do your homework tonight? Or, in high school where teachers took attendance and, you get to college and it's a totally new experience. And so it's like, wow, they don't take attendance. I got three classes today. I got breaks. And so just kind of getting them on track and developing good skills and study habits. And that's kind of the one thing our program, I think, is really good at. And you can tell with their academics and their GPAs. And I thought this first semester for those new kids, the new student athletes, went extremely well. It's a work in progress. It's always something that needs to be done.
If I could bring up one more point academically, there is a large cast that helps the student athletes pull all this off, whether it's the professors on campus who are so accommodating, the athletic advising crew academically, the folks here on this side of the house with some of the compliance issues, certainly your assistant coaches. There's a lot of people who, as you said, they're not doing it for them, but can be the guiding lights or just help shed some light in certain situations.
Yeah. That's one of the things that I am very, very happy about here at South Dakota State because we have all those resources for our kids. They don't just go into the abyss and handle it all themselves. We have so many different people that have a hands-on kind of knowledge or experience with our guys that we walk them through. And again, like you said, we don't do it for them, but you have to educate them. You have to give them the skills and teach them the skills to be able to navigate this part of their life. Because again, it is new for a lot of our kids. And a lot of people think, hey, you just, take the next step and you're on to college and everything is fine. Me personally, I struggled. When I was a young student athlete, my first couple years at school, because it was a new world and I didn't really use all those resources that I had, and you learn from your experiences. And so for me and for my staff, we take that serious, and we try and do our absolute best to provide those resources to our kids and educate them. So again, I think the first semester for those new incoming student athletes is going extremely well, and we're only a day away from finishing up and on to the next semester.
And before we get to the next semester, you've got some competitions, particularly the one we want to talk about this weekend, Saturday, heading down to Lincoln, Nebraska, taking on the Cornhuskers. And much like the duel with Minnesota, to face a Power 5 program, wherever you want to look at it, to go on the road, this quality foe away from Brookings, it will not be easy.
Nope, it's gonna be a dogfight. I mean, just like every one of our matches. I mean, I think we're ranked right now 14th in the country, and you know, when you hear that, it's like, oh, you know, I mean, we should be going in there and wiping the mats or whatever it is. But no, we're talking about high level programs here, and for most of our you know, fans and people that are knowledgeable about wrestling, I mean, we're in the Power 5 conference, we're in the Big 12, and so every time we step on the mat, we're going against, you know, the best of the best, and this is another challenge. I mean, Nebraska is a top 10 program, you know, probably 5 to 7-ish area, and every single match is going to be contested. I mean, you know, from 25 all the way up the line, this could be an extremely exciting duel. And I think they're favored heavily in three of them. We're favored in three of them. And we got about, you know, four toss-up matches that could go really either way. So I'm looking forward to it. I think we've had a great first semester. Obviously, you know, kind of getting through some of the early season nagging little injuries, if you will. But everybody is to the point right now where we're back for the most part. And we're going to go down there and look to put on a show. I mean, that's, I think, one of the things that we do as a program when we go out there and compete. I think we can, when it matters most, we compete best. And there's another opportunity for our guys to step on that mat against, you know, a neighboring state, a border state that we not only compete against, we recruit against, and it's gonna be exciting. I expect a good crowd. I expect our guys to go out there and compete at a very high level and put points on the board.
Last point I want to make with you, Damion, and you alluded to it in some respects, but as opposed to a lot of the sports at South Dakota State, which really are trying to compete at the top of their conference, you have a sport like football, a sport like wrestling, where you're nationally ranked at your level. You're one of the top programs in all of the country. And so it's not a case of when you face a Minnesota or Nebraska, hey, isn't this a cool opportunity? It's we're just as good, if not better than them, and we need to go out and prove it. That's the mindset of your program.
Absolutely. You know, like you said, this isn't a conference kind of thing. Hey, we got a great opportunity here. We're wrestling, you know, a school like Nebraska. No, this is the job. I mean, like, let's just be honest here. You know, you look at our schedule, you look at who we compete against, and this is another day at the office. You know, and for some people out there, some programs, I mean, you know, they may say, oh man, great, you're wrestling in Minnesota or Nebraska. Like, no man, this is what we do. And that's the unique thing about wrestling. You know, there's only, you know, 70 some odd Division I programs, and being in the Big 12 conference, this is par for the course. I mean, we're gonna compete against the absolute best out there, and we're gonna beat the best. You know, but it's a process, and the nice thing, you know, we talk about the season, and we're still in December, we're still in that first semester, and so all of these things, all of the competitions, all of the tournaments that we compete in are all preparation. And you know, because the season is long, and we have a great schedule, and I think we have set it up in a way to keep progressing, keep moving the needle in the upward direction to help prepare us for March.